Welcome back. The Department of Human Settlements, together with the Community Schemes Ombud Service Board, will today officiate the opening of the new office of the CSOS in Nelspruit in Mpumalanga. The CSOS was established to regulate the conduct of parties within community schemes and to ensure good governance. It came into operation on the 7th of October 2016. For more on this, we now speak to Tumelo Machogo. Tumelo, good morning. Thank you so much for making time for us. Just a quick one based on what you said a bit earlier on during that initial crossing that we had. Would the CSO office also be able to deal with disputes in relation to, for instance, when there is a new development that has come up and the money has been paid to those developers? However, though, the infrastructure is not up to par in terms of what was promised to the people who bought into the properties.
Well, indeed, Aldrin, that's actually what the CSO is going to be doing. It's going to be dealing with this dispute, the dispute from property might use materials that are subpar, and then when the people start buying houses, they start realizing that these houses are actually are not built like with good materials. They can still go to CSOS instead of going to lawyers first. They can go to CSOS and start trying to resolve those matters. But also matters such as if you want to have a cat in a complex and the complex say no, we're not allowing cats in this complex, that can also be taken to CSOS. They can be resolved at CSOS instead of it can be resolved at CSOS, but also start at the body corporate. That's where you start with the body corporate to ensure that you resolve those matters with body corporate first, but also before you can take it to CSOS. But CSOS is going to be resolving those matters, so they're going to be working with tenants, homeowners, and also property developers, and also body corporates in this community to ensure that they actually resolve those matters. You understand that in the country alone, we've got about 70,000 of these community schemes, so it's a lot, because more and more people are moving into the urban areas. They want to live in a complex, in a gated community. That's why they're moving there. But also, there are issues there. There are many issues, and these issues must be resolved. And the people that are going to be resolving this issue, these issues are CSOS. But let's now speak to the Deputy Minister of Human Settlement, Pamela Tshwete. Thank you so much for joining us. We know this is the fifth office that has been opened in the country. What does this office mean to the department and also to the stakeholders and the institution CSO?
Let me start by saying we're very excited as the family of human settlements. This is the fifth satellite office of CSOS, and we are proud to say this office is going to be accessible and affordable to our people, because headquarters at the moment are at Centurion. And the portfolio committee of human settlements, their worry was, how do we as entity of CSOS making sure that the offices all over, so far, this is the fifth satellite office. So far, our intention is to have satellite offices in all provinces so that it's easy for stakeholders to utilize the offices.
But also, is this institution making a difference in the lives of stakeholders, especially tenants? Because people are complaining a lot of issues, especially when they live in these complexes. They say, you know, I've got a cat, but my cat is not allowed, and this is the only thing that I have, and it's my companion. I don't have to. But is it helping the stakeholders and also the people that are building these houses? Is it helping anyone?
Of course, yes. The reason why we have these offices is to make sure that stakeholders and also communities in our schemes should be happy. Everyone should be happy. Once we build houses, it shouldn't be people that are not happy. And these satellite offices are made to make sure that people, it's easy for them to bring disputes in all these offices, and we attend to those disputes. And we encourage that all schemes should be reported to CSOS, because we want to also regulate within the community and make sure that all schemes are regulated and monitored. And what is good about the CSOS, they give free training to all the stakeholders. We give them free so that they're able to make sure that they implement all the work of CSOS.
But do you think it's reaching the right people, and is it succeeding in reaching the right people? Because most people don't know about it. Most people would actually take their complaints and their matter to the lawyers instead of CSOS. Do you think it's reaching the people?
That's exactly what we are trying to avoid, that people spend monies and go to lawyers. We're making things easy for them. That is why we're saying, we are really saying we want to make sure that all provinces, especially the rural areas, as you see, the urbanization is spreading in all provinces now. And yet before it wasn't like that. But we want to make sure that all people that are not happy, disputes are being attended to by CSOS. And I want to assure you that so far, we are doing so good with the stakeholders.
May just talk to me about, we know there's a mini acting CEO, Ms. Dembelihle Mbata. When are you guys appointing a new CEO? Because the organization has not had a CEO for a very long time. So when are you guys appointing a CEO?
Let's start by thanking my minister, Mr. Kupait, because when she joined the office, there is stability in the department. All entities are stabilized, and I want to make sure that I explain to the community that we are in an advanced stage, and it already went to the interviews are done. It's now going to be in the cabinet, and once it goes to the cabinet, everything will be done. And so far, I think it's very close. We are in an advanced stage.
May, one last question. I just want to ask about your department. I know you guys have been having a drive of title deeds, giving people title deeds. Just talk to us about how's the process going, and then also people like welcoming getting these title deeds, because I know a lot of people want to be able to say, I'm a homeowner.
I'm very excited. You're talking to someone who has a passion of issuing out title deeds. Yesterday, as you know, that we are all here. The African National Congress and also the ruling party is here. It is our 112th anniversary. So yesterday we went to Ehlanzeni where we were distributing 619 title deeds, and we took a resolution as a department. The MECs took a resolution with the minister that we should make sure that every Friday we issue out title deeds. Remember, we have a backlog from pre 1994. We are still dealing with the backlog, and there is a progress now. And I want to thank again Minister Kupai for the sterling job that she's doing.
And also quickly, just about the backlog, how far is the backlog of building RDP houses? Just the numbers, in terms of the numbers, if you have the numbers in your head.
It's difficult to talk about numbers in the media when you are not sure, but I can, you know, tell people that each province, I think, was issued more than 5,000 in each province, but I don't have the total number of all the provinces. But we can give you that information anytime. We're proud that everybody is happy and we're giving out titles every Friday.
Deputy Minister, thank you so much for speaking to us. Deputy Minister Pamela Tshwete speaking to us there about the CSOS office that has been opened here in the province, and also speaking to us about title deeds that they have been issuing out to the communities. You remember that a lot of people, and especially with bad luck of RDP houses being built for people, a lot of people have been wanting title deeds, saying that they want to have title deeds so they can also be called homeowners. Aldrin?